One, I've observed that Peru is quite a large country. So in terms of forest management, they need to do a little bit more as opposed to Uganda. Uganda is a small country. So in terms of resources, we need not more than Peru to conserve, to manage our forests very well. And of course, deal with the tenure issues that are a major challenge for our forestry management in both countries. So, you know, so far I've learned that the problems we have are almost similar. The tenure problems we have are almost similar. There are illegal activities going on in Peru as well, just like it is in Uganda. Issues of land titling is also happening in Uganda, and the challenges that go along with that I've observed seem to be similar. But what is unique about Peru is that we have the indigenous groups that have been talking about, and I've already met you know, some indigenous people here. We don't have many of such. The ones that we have in Uganda are the very minority in terms of you know, engagement. We don't engage them that much, but I see that there's a lot of engagement of the indigenous people, and I think it is useful because they influence how many of our forests are being managed in one way or the other. So that is very unique thing that I learned, and I hope to take back home. I also learned that there are regional governments in Peru which are very autonomous, even in terms of forest management, resource management, except it is similar with us. We also have regional governments, but they're called districts in Uganda, and they are controlled by the center in many ways. But here the controls are only the fact that the regional government are supposed to work within the laws that have been prepared by the national government. So that is the sort of difference that I see, and how they have been structured is something that I may need to take back home, because they seem to be more autonomous than ours. The opportunities for that, but there are also disadvantages for the autonomy. So it is something that I'm yet to conclusively pick in today's subnational engagement, because I'm sure there are some unique aspects that are related to that as well.